Okay, I need to break down the that 5x5 piece of Baltic, and instead of trying to manipulate that whole big thing over my table saw in my tight space, I want to show you how I break down sheet goods with this new setup. I just got these straps and put them out on my table. And I've got these scraps, so as long as the X's are up and in the same orientation, and then I've got a couple of, here are fours and the numbers are up. And these things just slip together with, just these dominoes, just slip tenon dominoes here. And so this will give me a grid work to do all my cutting on. Can set this up pretty quickly and then break it down. Okay, that's good enough. So now when I flip the thing, it's not gonna move around on me. So let me get this sheet up here. You know, table saw does a fantastic job at making parallel cuts, but anything over 12 inches or so becomes kind of hard to cut. And I'm not a fan of sleds, so I don't use sleds. So the first thing I always like to do is just trim, give myself a nice straight edge on the end. Okay, so here I want to make my first 90 degree cut right here. Now you can come up with any kind of arrangement that you want, but I'm lucky enough that I have one of these Festool multifunction templates. And when you set this thing square where the edges are flush all around, and I actually had to trim the T-nuts just a little bit because as they were locking down, they were kind of kicking out and making a little bit of an error. And so I trimmed those off, but I can put my Mitutoyo up to this, and it's right on. So here I've got this, I've got a little fence on it, and I just set this guy to that. And as far as I can tell, I'm getting really, really accurate cuts doing it like this, and it's pretty darn quick. Now at the other end where I don't have a way to get this clamp on, I made a couple of these little gizmos. And these are just, this slides into the Festool thing right here. And it allows me to slip a clamp this way, but still be out of the way of the saw, the motor of the saw. So let's make this cut. When I first started doing this and I didn't have the dominoes in there, I would sling these boards around and everything would get out of whack because this would pull things and I didn't have the grid pattern underneath that I wanted. Okay, so that's a cut edge there. So let's put the multifunction gear back up there. And let's just trim off a little bit here. good. Should have put a backer up underneath there, but I had just barely the right amount of blade out. Okay, I'm done with this, and I'm going to break this guy down. I'll put this back over where it belongs. Hung it safely on the wall back behind my vacuum station. Break all this down and then cut my stock to length using my longer storage stick on the table saw here. All right, let me break this setup down and get back to work. There's my Festool. It lives in this special drawer right here, that multifunction jig. And the short pieces just get tucked back over here. Okay, just as a reasonable test here, you can look at, you know, here's my piece. Stood up on the edge, well, the square mark is on that side here, but you know, here, this is a precision machinist table, and here's a Mitutoyo, and you know, it's just, there's nothing. It's just perfectly square. It's just perfectly square. There's no gap, no light whatsoever. And so now I can just use the, you know, since the table saw shines at parallel cuts, now I can just use this edge to cut my piece down to length. So I set my fence over here to my story stick, and let me just go over here and make these cuts. absolute perfection.
Okay, well, let me get these guys sanded up and I'm going to glue my drawers up now.